I will totally admit that I have never been a huge lover of vocalizing, but I am here to tell you that vocalizing is one of the most important tools you can do for your voice and yourself as a singer. Vocalizing is not just about warming up the voice. Yes, once you've vocalized properly, that is a benefit. Your voice will be warm to be able to handle whatever kind of abuse you're going to put it through. But vocalizing, more importantly, is about getting all of the gears oiled up, getting everything in the vocal tract aligned and in balance, getting your breath moving properly, getting your voice to be focused where it is that you want it to be focused in order to support whatever repertoire that you're going to be singing. And therefore, it is really, really important that you are vocalizing every single day, even when you are not planning on singing for a long period of time, but instead vocalizing every single day to just keep those gears oiled up. So the thing about vocalizing is that it doesn't have to take in half an hour of your time. It should never actually take a half an hour of your time, and certainly not 45 minutes or an hour of your time, okay? Vocalizing can do exactly what you need it to do in 10 minutes. It just means that what you have to do is you have to, number one, go in with a plan, and number two, vocalize mindfully. This is the most important thing, that when you are actually singing your vocal exercises, you're not thinking about what you're going to have for dinner that night, or trying to go through your to-do list of you have to take out the dogs after you finish this, and you know what happened on Grey's Anatomy the night before, whatever. You're not thinking about that. What you have to do is you have to make sure that you are focusing on the exercises that you are doing and what the purposes of those exercises are, because every exercise has a particular purpose, whether it is to get your breath going, to open up your chest voice, to change the colors, to practice get your support underneath you, to practice sotto voce, whatever it may be. Every exercise has a reason, and you need to absolutely think about what is the purpose of this exercise that I'm doing so that you can make sure that you're doing it correctly. So one of the things that you want to do is you want to make sure that you have a very clear plan in your vocalizing regimen for the day. Now the plan can change day to day, depending on what it is that you're doing, how long it is that you have time for in your vocalizing. But before you open your mouth, make sure that you have a very clear plan as to what it is that you are going to accomplish in that vocalization session. Okay? So having a clear plan then leads you to the order of vocalizes that you want to do. So perhaps you always start with vocalizes that actually just get your breath grounded and massage your vocal cords. So something very easy on a very easy vowel that is not going to strain you at all. Something that if you sing a very easy relaxed E vowel, then just sing a relaxed E vowel in short little scalar patterns. And don't take these first exercises up to the top of your range. Just work on your lower middle, going up to your middle voice, then taking your voice down into the lower part of your range, perhaps chest voice or whatever it is that you need to be doing down there. Do two or three exercises just like this, very easy, that just get the breath moving, get the vocal cords vibrating. Okay? Then as you go on, perhaps the second part of your exercise, your exercises are that you start to open up the voice a little bit more. You use more open vowels, O's and A's, and you start extending your range slightly. So maybe you are now going to do going up to fifths, or maybe you're even going to go up an octave. But the thing is that what you want to do is make sure that you're not going up too quickly and you're not going to the very top of your range yet, okay? Still start in the lower middle part of your range and maybe go up to your secondo passaggio, all right? And you're just then opening up the voice, maybe using some exercises that get the breath moving a little bit. So melismatic exercises like or and then taking that up to, as I said, perhaps your secondo passaggio. Then, once you feel like your voice is really starting to find that pliability, then what you can do is you can start extending your range. So you go up above your passaggio and you start singing exercises that maybe extend an octave, maybe they extend a tenth, and maybe they're melismatic, or maybe they you are doing exercises that actually help you pop up to high notes. Whatever it is, you do those exercises last. But one piece of advice that I'm going to tell you that I was given by a very famous conductor when I was performing with her is that she heard me vocalizing in my dressing room and she knocked on my door and she said, "Now, Regina, don't leave it all in the dressing room." And she was absolutely right. One thing that you want to do is you do not want to vocalize yourself into fatigue, okay? Which means you don't need to vocalize for many, many minutes or half hours or hours. And also, you do not need to sing every high note that you sing for 20 minutes, okay? If you have vocalized properly in the lower and middle part of your range, your high notes will be there. Do one or two exercises at the end of your vocalization session that reaches those high notes and then leave them alone. You will then find that once you start singing your repertoire, those high notes will be there. So that's just a little taste of why vocalizing is important and how you can structure your vocalization sessions, okay? If you're interested in more detailed information about vocalizes, I have a course called Voracious Vocalizing that you should check out. In this course, I am going to discuss all of the important ways to vocalize depending on what you are vocalizing for, whether it be for classical singing, for belting, for musical theater mixing, whatever it is. I give you ideas as to how to structure your vocalization sections in much more detail. And I also give you a detailed and sample vocalization session that you can just download onto your phone or any other listening device and sing along with every day if you would like to do it. So check that out. The link is in the bio below. Happy vocalizing.